So my name is Bastiaan Rutjens. I'm an assistant professor at the University of Amsterdam, and I'm primarily interested in the motivational sort of reasons for people to, you know, endorse certain scientific beliefs and worldviews, as well as more religious worldviews. So I mainly look at the extent to which, you know, uncertainty and lack of control trigger the need to sort of find compensation for this, you know, lack of control, lack of certainty. For example, by endorsing certain scientific or secular worldviews in order to sort of restore the idea that the world is an orderly and meaningful place. So in the current project, we have been looking at, you know, certain biases that people might have against scientists. What we find is quite interesting. If you look at, you know, there has been some survey results showing that people actually see scientists as, you know, being among the most prestigious and respected occupations in at least the US, Canada, and the UK. However, if we sort of venture beyond the survey results a little bit, you can see that people actually associate scientists with a bunch of moral morality violations. So for example, people, as we show in our research, associate scientists on an intuitive level with violations of the binding moral foundations, so the moral foundations that really are concerned with the welfare of the group. So people think that scientists are less able to, you know, endorse moral foundations related to purity concerns, authority concerns, and sort of in-group loyalty concerns. However, what's interesting is that scientists aren't associated with violations of the sort of individualizing moral foundations, which are more about the welfare of the individual, sort of the rights and welfare of the individual. So scientists aren't perceived as violating fairness and care related concerns. So scientists aren't cheats, basically, right? So that's what we find in this research. And if we try to sort of get an answer as to why people think that scientists violate these binding moral foundations, what we see in more when we ask people more explicitly about, you know, what they think about what drives scientists in terms of their values and motivations, we see that people actually think that scientists sort of put morality on a second level, right? So what the scientists are primarily concerned in people's minds about sort of knowledge acquisition and satisfying a curiosity. And this might sometimes trump, you know, morality concerns. And that's why people sometimes feel that scientists can do terrible things. It's not because they're evil or perceived as evil, but it's more that they are seen as, you know, being more interested in certain other motivations besides morality.